Right. Good morning, everyone. Welcome to physics class again. In the previous class, we discussed about the concept of PN junction diode and also formation of the PN junction diode. But in general, before we going to explain the PN junction diode, again let us recall the previous section or previous class. First one, semiconductors are of two types, intrinsic semiconductors and also extrinsic semiconductors. Intrinsic means pure semiconductors are known as the intrinsic semiconductors. To increase the conductivity of pure semiconductors, some impurities are added. That's why the resulting crystal is known as the extrinsic or impure semiconductor. So, the process of adding of impurities to the pure semiconductor is known as the doping. And examples of pure semiconductors are silicon and germanium, or all the fourth group elements are the best example for semiconducting materials, pure semiconducting materials. So the doping materials, depending on the nature of the doping concentration or doping materials, extrinsic semiconductors are also classified into two types. They are called P-type and N-type. Just suppose a pentavalent impurity is doped with the pure semiconductor, the resulting crystal contains majority number of electrons. That's why it is called as N-type semiconductor. Otherwise, suppose a trivalent impurity is doped with the pure semiconductor, resulting crystal contains majority number of positive charge carriers. That's why it is called as a P-type semiconductor. Okay, na? So either pentavalent impurity or trivalent impurity is doped with the pure semiconductors, they will convert into either P-type or N-type semiconductors. Say for example, how the PN junction diode is formed. In general, in the previous class, I can say that a P-type material and also N-type material both are joined together such that at the point of junction of P and N-type material, there is a diode is formed. That one is known as the PN junction diode. But that process is not acceptable in general. Then how do you create a PN junction diode? Suppose this it is taken as a silicon or germanium, intrinsic semiconductors. Now, on one side, this intrinsic semiconductor is doped with pentavalent impurity, and again on the other side, it is doped with a trivalent impurity. Means, suppose here, on this side, a pentavalent impurity is doped, means this will convert into N-type semiconductor. On the other side, a trivalent impurity is doped such that it becomes a P-type semiconductor. In P-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are the positive charge holes, and there are some minority carriers also. Minority carriers means electrons. In N-type semiconductors, there is a large number of free electrons, majority number of free electrons, and there are some minority number of positive charge holes. So sometimes in IT board examination, it is asked that in 2 mark question, what are the majority carriers and minority carriers in N-type and P-type semiconductors? It is a question. In P-type semiconductor, the majority charge carriers are the positive charge holes and minority carriers are the electrons. Whereas in N-type semiconductor, majority charge carriers are the electrons and minority carriers are the positive charge holes. Right? So on one side of this pure semiconductor, a trivalent impurity is doped, and also on the other side, a pentavalent impurity is doped such that electrons and positive charge holes are formed on the two sides of the silicon medium. So this is the plane which is perpendicular to both the sides. The plane dividing both P and N-type semiconductors is known as the PN junction. Now again, there is a force of attraction between the electron and also positive charge holes. That's why these electrons are tend to move towards the P-type and also maybe the quality charge holes are tend to move towards the n pi. Suppose if electron they move from n to p side and recombine with this positive charge holes, it becomes a neutral. At the same time, this positive charge hole chase, this can be moved from p to n side, and this two are combined together, this forms a path and a neutral region. So that's why a neutral region in between p type and n type semiconductors is formed, so that due to recombination, this neutral region will be increased up to certain thickness. Suppose this is the neutral region. Therefore, the neutral region developed between p type and n type semiconductor due to recombination of electrons and positive charge holes is known as a depletion layer. Depletion layer. So in this case, this depletion layer contains a neutral region, means there is no positive charge carriers or electrons inside the depletion layer. Are you understand? This is the depletion layer. Right? Suppose if one electron from n side, they leave from n to p side, means at the position of the electron, there is a positive charge ion is formed. Meaning, second electron comes from n side to p side, at that point also positive charge ion is formed. That means, at the boundary of n side, a positive charge is created. Positive charge ions are created, these are the immobile ions. At the same way, on this side, negative charge immobile ions are formed on the p side. Okay? Therefore, positive charge and negative charge ions are formed on the two sides of this neutral region. There exists an electric field is developed. Electric field capital E, which is taken from positive to negative. Electric field is developed across the p-n junction diode, and thickness of the depletion layer is equal to d. Then the potential difference across the depletion layer is given by V. V is equivalent to E into D. V equal to E into D, where E is equal to electric field intensity and D is equal to thickness of the depletion layer. In general, thickness of the depletion layer is in the order of micrometers, means approximately is equal to 10 power minus 6 meters. 10 power minus 6 meters. Barrier potential, this potential difference across the two layers of the depletion layer is called barrier potential. This barrier potential may be different, that is according to the semiconducting material test we are taking here. Suppose in case of germanium, this barrier potential is approximately equal to 0.2 volts, and again in case of silicon, barrier potential is equal to 0.7 volts. So here, in case of germanium semiconductor, what is the value of electric field intensity developed across the depletion layer? E is also equivalent to, you know, V by D. V is equal to, what is this value? 0.3 by D is equal to 10 power minus 6. That is equal to 0.3 into 10 to the power 6 or 3 into 10 to the power 7 volt per meter. 3 into 10 to the power 7 volt per meter. This is the electric field intensity in between the depletion layer. That's why electric field intensity will be maximum, or a maximum electric field intensity that can be created between the two sides of the depletion layer. Okay. Suppose in the same way, in case of depletion layer, it becomes a neutral region. Neutral region means there are completely covalent bonds are formed. Only, you know the structure of p-type semiconductor or n-type semiconductor. For n-type semiconductor means a pentavalent impurity like antimony. Antimony contains 5 valence electrons, and out of 5, 4 valence electrons they are involved in the covalent bond in the nearest silicon atoms. One excess electron is there. This excess electron in the orbital, this is named as the n-type semiconductor. You know, this excess electron inside the n-type semiconductor that can move from n side to p side and recombine with the positive charge holes. Only this electron will be disappears. Remaining structure is involved in the depletion layer. So at any moment, maybe this covalent bond is broken inside the depletion. one electron maybe comes out from outside the valence bond. At that place, there is a positive charge hole is generated. Second electron is also comes out means two electrons are free and two positive charge holes are generated. So inside the depletion layer or inside the neutral region, if the covalent bonds are broken, once again electrons and positive charge holes pairs are generated. Electron and positive charge holes are created. Therefore, this positive charge electron, negative charge electron and also positive charge holes, they tend to move either p side or n side. You know, electric field intensity in between p type and n type semiconductor, it is taken from n to p. Okay, this is the electric field intensity. In this depletion layer, electron and also positive charge holes are generated. Maybe the electrons, you know, electrons are always accelerated opposite the electric field. Positive charge holes are always accelerated along the field lines. That means electrons are moving towards n side, positive charge holes are moving towards p side. Please remember, my dear students, once these electron and positive charge holes are created in the depletion layer, electrons are moving towards the negative charge, n type semiconductor, positive charge holes are moving towards p type semiconductor, but these electron and positive charge holes, they cannot recombine with each other inside the depletion layer. They continuously move towards n side and also towards p side. That's why electrical conduction takes place through the p emitter layer. So these electron and positive charge holes developed in the depletion layer are strongly depleted into n-type and also p-side regions. That's why a current will flow through the p-emitter layer. This type of current is called as the drift current. Are you understand? This is called as the drift current. So, drift current is caused by the breaking of covalent bonds and the charging particles or charge carriers, they move towards n-side or p-side. They constitute the electric current. Whereas, before the formation of the depletion layer, electrons are moving towards p side and holes are moving towards n side. That can be takes place only due to high concentration or defective concentration of the holes and electrons in between p type and n type semiconductors. Right? Therefore, due to difference in charge carriers in p type and n type semiconductor, current is said to be flows through the p emitter diode. This type of current is said to be diffusion current. Are you understand? Diffusion current is mainly caused by the difference in charge carriers in n-type and p-type semiconductors. Drift current is caused by the breaking of covalent bonds inside the depletion layer, and they are strongly pushed into p-side and also n-side. They create some current which is called as the drift current. That is the difference between diffusion current and also drift current. Right? Say for example, this is a p-emitter diode. Okay. In case of p-emitter diode or in a semiconductor, both electrons and positive charge holes are crossing through the p-emitter diode. That means the total current through the p-emitter diode is mainly by the electrons as well as positive charge holes. Therefore, total current I is equal to current due to the electrons plus current due to the positive charge holes. Again, you know, in current electricity, we know very well a concept which is called as the mobility. Mobility, it is defined as mu is equal to Vd by capital V. This is called mobility. Vd is equal to drift velocity. Vd is equal to drift velocity. Capital E is equal to electric field intensity. Therefore, drift velocity per unit electric field intensity is called as the mobility of the charge carriers. You know, drift velocity corresponding to electrons, it is far greater than drift velocity of positive charge holes. Why? Because electrons are the lesser mass particles, and also they are lying on the outermost shells. Value charge holes are lying. Value charge holes. Their mass is approximately very high as compared to the electrons. That's why velocity for electrons is greater than velocity of value charge holes. That's why drift. Mobility of electrons is greater than mobility of the value charge holes. Remember this point. Now again, what is the SI unit for mobility? V is the velocity. Velocity is represented in meter per second by electric field intensity represented in volt per meter. Volt per meter. That is equal to meter per second into meter per volt. That is equal to meter square per volt per second. That is the SI unit for mobility of the charge carriers. Right? Which carrier having more mobility? Generally, we say that mobility of electron is greater than the mobility of positive charge holes. So, this is the concept about the mobility. Also, Vd is the drift velocity. What is the formula for relation between drift velocity and also electric current? Drift velocity Vd is equal to electric current I is equal to V by NAE. Or V is equal to I into V is equal to drift velocity V is equal to I by NAE, where N is equal to number of electrons per unit volume, means number density of electrons. I is equal to current, A equal to area of cross section of the conductor, and E is equal to magnitude of the charge of electron, which is equivalent to 1.6 × 10⁻¹⁹ coulombs. Right? N is the number of electrons per unit volume, number density of electrons. Okay. From this relation, current I is equal to V into N into A into E. Remember this formula. Sometimes drift velocity is also denoted by Vd. So I is equal to Vd into N into A into E. But in general, in case of semiconductors, total current Q is given by I is equal to current into electrons plus current into positive charge. Therefore, IE in terms of drift velocity can be represented by I is equal to VE, NE, capital A into E, where area of cross section of the semiconductor for electrons and also holes remains same, charge remains same, plus for positive charge holes, this can be written as VH, NH, A into E. Right? Also, for intrinsic semiconductors, NE is equal, NH is equal, NI. In simply concentration. For intrinsic semiconductors, number of electrons is equal to number of positive charge holes. So NE is equal to NH is equal to NI, where NI is equal to intrinsic concentration. Now, what is the product? NE into NH is equivalent to NI square. NE into NH is equal to NI square. Because for intrinsic, the product of these two is equivalent to NI into NI equal to NI square. In case of extrinsic semiconductors, the relation between NE and NH can be represented by NE into NH is equal to NI square. Remember the point. So here, NE is equal to NH is equal to NI, where NI is equal to intrinsic semiconductors. Sorry. Number density of intrinsic semiconductor. So from this formula, we can count these terms Ni into A into E into, and what are the remaining values? Drift velocity for electron plus drift velocity for positive charge. This is the formula for electric current. Ni into A into E into VE plus VH. VE plus VH. Next again, the potential difference across the conductor is given by potential difference V is equal to, you know, I into R. V equal to I into R. Therefore, potential difference V is equal to I into R. I is equal to N by into, here in case of we equal I into R, Ni into A into E into VE plus VH into R. R is also replaced by rho into L by E. You know, resistance of the conductor is directly proportional to length and inversely proportional to area of cross section. Then R is proportional to L by A and R is equal to rho into L by E. Where rho is equal to resistivity or specific resistance of the conductor. That's why this is equal to here A and A are cancelled. That is Ni into E into rho into L into VE plus VH. VE plus VH. It is the potential difference. Also, electric field intensity in between two ends of the conductor is given by E is equal to V into D. Here D is equal to total length of the conductor is equal to L. But E is equal to V into L. That is V, potential difference. It is equal to Ni into E is equal to V by L. V by L. Ni into E into rho into L by L into VE plus VH. Here L and L cancel. Therefore, Ni into E into rho VE plus VH. Or from this, 1 by rho is equal to 1 by rho. E value of this one. 1 by rho is equal to Ni into E into VE by capital E plus VH by capital E. That is equal to Ni into E into VE by E. VE is the drift velocity electron. Drift velocity by electric field intensity is called mobility. But this can be replaced by mu E plus VH by E is equal to mu H. Where mu E is equal to VE by E, mu H is equal to VH by E. From this 1 by rho is equal to this value. What is 1 by rho? Rho is the resistivity. Reciprocal of resistivity is also called as conductivity. Therefore, conductivity sigma is equal to Ni into E into mu E plus mu H. So this is very important formula. This is the formula for conductivity of semiconductors. Total conductivity sigma is equal to Ni into E into mu E plus mu H. But remember this point, remember this formula. There are so many problems regarding this formula. Sigma is equal to Ni into E into mu E plus mu H. Right? Suppose in case of N-type semiconductors, in case of N-type semiconductors, majority charge carriers of the electrons. So, mu H value will be negligible or compared with mu E. Therefore, sigma is equal to Ni into E into mu E. Enough, approximately. Whereas in case of P-type semiconductor, that means mu E will be negligible or compared with mu H. In that case, Ni into E into mu H. Then, what is the link between Ne, Ni, NH? Ni into NH is equal to, sorry, Ne into NH is equal to Ni square. Ne into NH is equal to Ni square. So these are the formulas corresponding to resistivity and also conductivity in case of a semiconductor. Right? Okay. Next one. How the beam insulator is working? Generally, what are the uses of the p-n junction diode? P-n junction diode can be used as a rectifier. Rectification means the process of converting alternating current into direct current is known as the rectification. A device which is used to convert AC into DC is known as the rectifier. Right? So, how the p-n junction diode can be used as a rectifier? Before we explain the rectifier, First one, what is meant by biasing of a PE junction diode? What are the types of biasings? Biasing means the process of connecting the PN junction diode to the external battery is called as biasing. The process of connecting PN junction diode to the external cell or external battery is called as the formal bias. Sorry, biasing of the cell. Generally, biasing is of two types. First one, forward bias. Here, there are some more points regarding the PN junction diode. See clearly, positive charge nuclear ions are there in n-type semiconductor. Negative charge ions, nuclear ions, are towards the p-side. That means this is having negative potential, this is having positive potential. Next one, what is the nature of the graph between potential and also distance? On x axis is the length of potential, on y axis is the distance. Suppose it is taken at the junction of p type and n type nucleus. At that junction, potential is equal to 0. While going from junction to this side, automatically the potential will be increases, and at this point, the potential is positive but becomes maximum. Okay? Again, you know, potential difference and electric field intensity E is equal to the formula V by V, or V is equal to E into V, where E is equal to uniform field, it remains constant. It is similar to y equal mx. That means nature of the graph graph between potential difference and also distance becomes a straight line passing through the origin like this. The straight line. So after this separation layer or towards n side, this potential difference remains constant, just we are increasing the distance also. Next, again, from this junction towards n side, negative potential will be increases like this as V is proportional to V. Negative potential. That means nature of the graph becomes like this. Okay? Beyond this line, potential remains constant. So this is the nature of the graph between potential difference and also distance. Potential difference and also distance. Very important point, very important point. Next, again, what is the nature of the graph between charge carriers and distance? Charge carriers and distance. On y axis, charge carriers are taken, and on x axis, distance is taken. Now the graph becomes like this. So from this point to this point, and while we are going from center to this point, number of the charge carriers first increases, charge carriers are taken to one, reaches a maximum value, and again decreases up to this point. So keep in mind the shape of the graph diagram. The explanation will be in current electricity. I will explain this total concept in current electricity. So here, this is the nature of the law between potential difference and also distance. Next, what happens the width of the depletion layer on increasing the doping concentration? Chapter. This is the depletion layer, thickness of the depletion layer, width of the depletion layer. So this side as well as this side, some pentavalent impurities are more doped on this side. Means there are excess number of electrons are also produced. Trivalent impurities also doped more on this side. Holes number also increases. Electron number increases, holes number increases. There should be a force of attraction between these two. That's why electrons and positive charge holes, they are moving towards each other, such that the thickness of the depletion layer will be decreases. That means width of the depletion layer, width of depletion layer is proportional to 1 by doping. While increasing the doping, thickness of the depletion layer will be decreased. Also, width of the depression layer, it is directly proportional to temperature. Width of depression layer is directly proportional to temperature also. On increasing the temperature, width of the depression layer also increases. Remember this point. So these are very important points in case of construction problems or construction questions. Width of the depression layer depends on what parameters means. This depends on the nature of the amount of doping materials and also temperature. And how that depends doping concentration and also temperature means like this formulas. Okay. Next again, what is the forward bias of the digital layer and also reverse bias? Forward bias and reverse bias. Say for example, first one, forward bias of the p-n junction layer. So in case of forward bias, this is a p-n junction layer, this is p-type and this is n-type. P-type material consists of positive charge holes, n-type material consists of electrons. It is a depression layer. Suppose the p-type material is connected to one terminal of the battery, n type material is connected to another terminal of the battery. So the connecting the connection of the p-n junction layer with the connection of the p-n junction layer with the external battery is called as the bias. So in forward bias, p-type is connected to higher potential, n type is connected to lower potential. Remember this point. P-type is connected to higher potential, n-type is connected to lower potential. That means higher means positive polarity, lower means negative polarity. Positive to negative. Right? So this is known as the forward bias of the p-n junction layer. But in case of reverse bias, p-type is connected to lower potential and n type is connected to higher potential. This type of bias is known as the reverse bias. This is the reverse bias, right? Forward bias and reverse bias. Suppose here, in case of forward bias, p type material is connected to positive polarity of the battery. P-type material is having positive charge holes. Let this positive charge holes are strongly dependent from the positive polarity of the battery. That's why they tend to move towards density. Similarly, electrons in n-type semiconductor, they are repelled from the negative polarity. They tend to move towards P-type. That means holes in n-type, electrons towards this p-type, they are moving backwards. That's why the thickness of the depletion layer will be decreases. Let the barrier potential is equal to V. Applied potential depends on EMF of the battery is equal to V. Later sometimes EMF of the battery is represented by factor. Suppose if VV means electric field generated due to this in this depletion layer, that will be like this. This is the electric field intensity. Applied electric field intensity to the source is equal to this is opposite to field generated inside the depletion layer. Right? So, on increasing the EMF of the cell, but there should be a slight understanding question here. Electric field intensity is also represented by capital E. EMF of the battery is also represented by capital E. There is a little difficulty to identify which one is EMF and which one is electric field intensity. So, why this means electric field intensity, it cannot be represented like this. Only capital E indicates the EMF of the cell, EMF. Otherwise, this EMF of the cell is equal to capital E. Barrier potential is equal to V. Maybe like that. Suppose this is equal to capital. Suppose the EMF of the cell is equal to 2 volts. Barrier potential is equal to 0.5 some current will flow through the PMU cable. Suppose the barrier potential is equal to 0.5, sorry, applied EMF is equal to 0.1 volt, then electrons and positive charge goes, they come towards each other up to certain distance, they cannot cross the PMU cable. On increasing the EMF of the cell, increases up to 0.7. So is 0.7, is 0.7. That means almost the thickness of the depletion layer will be decreases and becomes narrow and becomes decreases to zero. Beyond this point means 0.8, 0.9, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, etc. The current starts flowing through the PMU cable. So the current passing through the PMU cable means applied EMF should be opposes the barrier potential. Applied EMF of the cell opposes the barrier potential. Net EMF in the circuit is equal to capital E minus E. This is the net EMF. Applied EMF is like this. Barrier potential is like this. Therefore, net EMF is equal to E minus E. Total current in the circuit in form as is equal to total EMF by total resistance. According to Ohm's law. That means E minus EB by RF, where RF is equal to resistance of the PN junction diode in forward bias. Resistance of the PN junction diode in forward bias. RF is equal to forward resistance. It is a formula for current passing through the PN junction diode in forward bias. Next one, for ideal PN junction diode, RF is equal to 0. For ideal diode, resistance in forward bias is equal to 0. Remember this one. Right? Here also, this is the negative point in reverse bias. P is connected to lower potential and N type is connected to higher potential. That's why positive charge holes are, they tend to move towards the negative polarity. Electrons are moving towards the positive polarity of the battery. That's why here the thickness of the depletion layer will be increases. Electrons are going around the square, holes are going around the square. Thickness of the depletion layer will be increases like this. So this is the barrier potential will be. In this condition, barrier potential and also applied EMF or EMF of the cell supports the barrier potential. Now in this case, net EMF in the circuit is equal to capital E plus E. Because applied EMF can support the barrier potential. That's why the depletion layer thickness will be increases. So there is no flaw connecting the PN junction diode and is connected in the reverse bias condition. కాబట్టి ఇక్కడ current I is equal to E plus VB by RF, RR. Resistance of the diode in reverse bias. In case of reverse bias, resistance is infinite. Something by infinity is approximately 0. Means current passing through the PN junction diode in reverse bias is equal to 0. Right? For ideal diode, resistance is equal to infinity in case of reverse bias. In case of forward bias, resistance is equal to 0. These are the differences between forward bias and also reverse bias of the PN junction diode. Are you understand? Keep in memory. In case of forward bias, P type is connected to higher potential, N type is connected to lower potential. Second point, applied EMF opposes the barrier potential. Net EMF in the circuit is equal to E minus V. Current in the circuit I is equal to E minus VB by RF, where RF is equal to diode resistance in form of gas. For ideal diode, RF is equal to 0. So in the same sense, it is reverse bias. See here, one example. Now the PN junction diode symbol. Symbol of the PN junction diode is represented by an arrow. This is the arrow with a vertical line. Right? And how do you know the symbol of the PN junction diode? That symbol indicates a straight line with arrow mark. Arrow mark indicates the direction of conventional current. Generally, you know, current direction is taken from P type to N type. Direction of current is taken from P to N. Okay? And there is a vertical line on N side. Say for example, suppose this is a PN junction diode, this is P type and N type. Suppose P is connected to plus 5 volts n is connected to 0. What, how do you say the bias of the diode, whether it is forward or reverse? It is said that this is a forward bias because P is connected at higher potential. Also, like this, this is connected plus 5 volts and this is connected plus 2 volts. And P is connected to plus 5, N is connected to plus 2 volts. This is at higher potential, this is at lower potential. Even though this is also said to be forward bias. Next one. Suppose if P is connected to minus 2 volts, N is connected to minus 5 volts, it is also said to be forward bias because minus 2 is greater than minus 5. P is at higher potential and N is at lower potential. Right? So all these are the examples for forward bias of the diode. Next again, reverse bias means when we are forward bias. Reverse bias means opposite. Suppose if P is connected to 0, N is connected to plus 5, it is reverse bias. If P is connected to plus 2, N is connected to plus 5. P is connected to minus 5, N is connected to minus 2. These are examples for reverse bias in case of P and E from below. Now again, in the next class I will explain the PN junction diode voltage current characteristics. Right? Thank you.